Revive.
What does that mean, Peter? Are we on like NBC or something?
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, they're going to hit the switch.
It is recording.
Okay, so we are recording. So I'd like to welcome everyone to the September 10th McIntyre subcommittee meeting. If we could just take roll call first. Councilor Trace.
Paige Trace, I'm here in the law library. I am with the fellow members of my subcommittee and three members of city staff.
John Tabor, here in the law library.
Doug McCaffrey, here in the law library.
Peter Whalen, here in the law library.
City staff present are Karen Connard, city manager, Bob Sullivan, city attorney, and Marion Steinke with the legal department.
Okay, so I think everyone received the minutes from the last meeting. If I could get a motion.
Move, we approve the minutes.
Second.
Which set?
Both sets. Okay, roll call vote. Councilor Trace.
Aye.
Councilor Tabor.
Yes.
Councilor McEachran.
Yes.
And the chair votes aye. So the minutes are approved from the last two meetings. So next we go to public comments. So I have, looks like there's two people in the waiting room. We'll take them and who signed up first. So I think Jerry Duffy. Jerry, would you like to say anything?
No, I'm just here to observe today, Peter, thank you.
Okay, and I think next we have Bill Downey's in the waiting room. Bill, do you have anything to say?
Hey Peter, you're there?
Yep, I can hear you.
Hey, I just want to thank everyone for all their hard work. I know you guys have done a lot of work and there's been so much going on in this world that it's good to see things pick up again. But again, thank you for all your hard work. And I feel like we're on track as we should have been back in 2016. So thank you all very much for your work.
Okay. Thanks, Bill. Thanks, Jerry. So I think the first order of business is probably to talk about the survey results. City Manager Carnard, do you want to give us kind of an update on where we stand with the survey and kind of what's going on?
Sure. Sorry for those of you who can't see me. I'm just out of range on the camera. That's not a bad thing in my book. I think I'm going to stay over here. To date, close to 3,700 surveys have been numbered and scanned. They've also been logged, which means staff have manually entered the information provided on the surveys. This took a total of 12 employees, including one temp hire. So essentially we have some raw data now. What we have done is we have contracted with the UNH Survey Center to help us interpret the data. But essentially we had 75% answer yes and 25% answer no to question two, which was, and I want to read it verbatim. This is, would you, changes to the project require a financial commitment from the city to achieve, would you still support them knowing this? 75% answered yes, 25% answered no. For question three, which was, would you prefer contemporary or traditional architecture for the new buildings in the project? Of the respondents, 84% answered traditional and 16% answered contemporary. So what we need to do, and primarily the reason we engaged UNH, is help us interpret the first question, which had five different options and started with the phrase, how would you like to see the project changed? Since there are costs associated with each change, please rank in order of importance. So we are due to get that interpretation back either tomorrow or the beginning of next week, and we will be able to share it with you at that time.
We've also captured, Michael, all the comments, you know, if there are any comments on any of the surveys.
Yeah.
And that's all going to be public record, any comments moving forward. You know, at this point, I think we probably should wait for UNH to kind of crunch the numbers. So they've kind of entered them into their database and they're going to help us interpret, you know, the first question, you know, where we're at there. And just to review that, if you rank these in order, and I'm just going to read them the way they're on the page. It was, the first question was larger, meaningful public open space, either indoor, outdoor, or combination in one piece between the federal building and Bow Street. And the second one was post office return to original location. Third was less density and mass on Bow Street side. Fourth was availability of public parking. And the last one was minor changes to existing project. So anyway, we're gonna wait on that. But, you know, just, you know, my kind of view of this that I see is, you know, on the second question, it sounds like to me, like the city, the residents are willing to make some financial commitment, you know, if the projects kind of change.
Great.
Which right. is kind of good news, you know, that they're willing to do that. Mm-hmm. But anyway, any other comments from the rest of the committee here? What do you guys think?
We're just waiting to be told what to do.
Okay. Maybe what we should do next is talk about what Justin Passé had spoken to us about, and you guys were going to kind of fill us in on that, about the $6 million number.
Just remind everybody, you're still in public session.
Right. You want to?
I'm happy to talk about it in public, but if the regulatory team would like to
go. Yeah.
Happy to do that.
Yes. I also have no problem talking about it in public session, but
okay.
We want to see what our partners think.
What do you guys think, Michael and John?
We're an open book, so it doesn't matter to us one way or the other.
Okay. So yeah, the
more information, obviously, that we have and the more detail, the better the price is always going to be. So working off estimates is always an inaccurate process.
Okay. All right. So why don't you tell us how you came up with that number?
Well, candidly, I'm not prepared to tell you how we came up with the number because it was the Redgate team that came up with it, and I haven't even, you know, been given the backup myself. So, but generally speaking, you know, we have a lot of soft costs into this project already, probably more than there should be for a project of the original size. Obviously, when you downsize a project, those soft costs spread over, you know, less square feet. But from 30,000 feet, you know, you're losing an income, and you are expensing your costs over a smaller area to, you know, to get return, and you add to the hardscape. And I can tell you that we looked at it as an office building, and the number was closer to 10. And so we went back to apartments, even though it's not really optimal to build, you know, less than close to 100 apartments if you can afford it or you can avoid it. But the apartments generate so much money that it made more sense to look at it as apartments than as office.
Okay. Were you thinking of building just one building behind McIntyre, or was that with two buildings with a number?
We lose one building. We do one building with apartments and retail on the first floor. And that's where the numbers shake out. I mean, I'm sure that we can that Redgate can clean those numbers up, and you're going to want someone like David Eaton to review them. You shouldn't take our word for it, but you know, these guys are very good at what they do, and I'm sure their numbers are, you know, pretty close to being spot on.
Right. Without getting into a lot of detail, I think what we probably need is we probably need that pro forma or whatever from the Redgate folks. And let us kind of review that, you know, moving forward. It's kind of hard. You know, we don't want to talk in abstracts here. I don't think that, you know, with a hard number and kind of a plan, I think it's much better to look at it. I don't know. What's everyone else think?
Yeah, I would think it's easier to look at hard numbers and have them vetted through whatever financial analysis that we would put that through to see, you know, to delve into the specifics, so to speak. So yeah, I would probably want to punt until we had the Redgate or the Redgate folks on the phone and Ralph or a representative to walk through those numbers or to share it with you know, a financial consultant to be able to share those with us. We'd like to.
Yeah, I mean, we'll send them to you and you guys can share them with whomever you want, obviously.
Right. So I think at this point, I mean, we've got two things we really need to kind of button up. I think the first one is to finish the survey results through UNH and then probably get your numbers from the Redgate folks and try to match all that up at this point. I think that would be the best thing to do. And I think that's a good kind of plan for moving forward, you know, for our next meeting. I think the other kind of piece that we, you know, since the last meeting, we've all gotten a tour of the building, the McIntyre building.
Yeah, I heard that.
From GSA, just to be totally open with you. And I was kind of blown away at the building inside. I mean, it's just a beautiful building. I think for a tenant going in there as an office building, I think it's probably one of the best views in Portsmouth that you could have from all those floors.
Yeah, well, HubSpot loved it, so.
Right, yeah. And I think it's flexible enough where you can take the walls down and everything else. So, you know,
yeah, no, it is, yeah.
We did see the asbestos, you know, above the drop ceilings and everything. I think the other part of the building was, I think John Dugan was pretty open about the city possibly taking over the building around the first of the year anyway, you know, when the FBI is the last tenant out of there. And we're in talks right now with GSA to try to facilitate that. So,
excellent.
And that doesn't negate our deal with you guys. I mean, that's just, you know, I think it would be great for the city to get possession of that. It just makes our position a lot stronger. So, but I think at this point, Michael, I think probably we should schedule another meeting and try to button up the survey and get that hard number from you guys so we have more really to talk about and start to plan on what's going to go on that site on the back.
Great.
So, Karen, what's next week maybe?
Week from today is the 17th.
So what if we did the same time on the 17th? Does that work for you guys?
I would have to zoom in.
Yep.
You want to zoom
you
in?
Can
do. I'll
okay.
I'm open.
Okay. All right. So why don't we figure the 17th at 3:00? We should have the survey all buttoned up. And then you can give us that proposal, you know, ahead of time, a day or two ahead, so we can all look at it. And we may have the person from UNH on the Zoom call too, where they can help us, you know, jointly interpret the data a little bit, try to give us some guidance moving forward.
Great.
Okay.
Well, I'll talk to the guys at Redgate and see how quickly we can put those numbers in, you know, in a formal spreadsheet. And then we'll send it right over to you and you can start peeling them apart and figure out which end is up.
All right, sounds great. John, you had something?
I was just gonna mention too that obviously there's a lot of public engagement with the survey. So we're feeling some obligation to make the results public. And that may happen next week as well.
Right.
Great.
So we may do a, it's possible we may do kind of a public information session with the survey results with a UNH person, just so the public, I'm already getting emails from people looking for those results. So, and we're going to be an open book about them. So including all the comments. All right. Anything else we need to talk about?
Looks like Jerry wants to say something, but you're muted, Jerry. You got to take your mute off.
Yeah, I was just waiting to be invited to say something if I'm not sure if it's appropriate at this point.
Well, Jerry, you had your time at the public comment, so.
Yeah, this is based on something that you said after that.
Well, I think next time when we meet, I think you have your chance to speak. You can actually write us in.
So you don't want to ask a question right now?
Well, you're not.
Jerry, if we start answering every particular question on that, breaks the precedent of what these meetings are intended to be.
Yeah, I was hoping in a smaller form, it could be a bit more of a dialogue, but that's okay. I understand.
Yeah, I mean, I'm trying to be open and, you know, transparent here, Jerry, so, but.
But there's only me asking a question. It's just
right, but if I allow you to do it, then I could have 20 other people at the next meeting.
Well, I only see Bill Downey at the moment, so.
Right, but he's not a participant. He's just listening, just as you
right.
were.
Got it, yeah, got it.
All right, so.
So the answer is no.
The answer is no at this point. Okay, you'll have plenty of time, Jerry. We're early in the process, trust me. So I think we're gonna adjourn, if that's okay. So I need a motion to adjourn.
Move to adjourn.
Okay.
Second.
Roll call vote. Councilor Trace.
Yes.
Councilor Tabor.
Yes.
Councilor McEachran.
Yes.
The chair votes aye. So we'll see you on the 17th, Michael. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks.
All right.